Yes, my name is Ruth. I just wanted to tell some experiences that the Lord has given me, miracles as He has done since I started serving Him. Yeah, there's arguments right now, and even I've heard from one of our pastors, they say, miracles, Jesus did miracles because in those days, there were no doctors like there are doctors today. It's like we only need miracles when doctors are not there. And we don't realize Jesus is the one who gives the doctors the wisdom even to heal others. Now, I was on the way as a colporter, and then I met this lady. When she opened the door, she was in tears, and she carried a child which was coughing, like whooping cough. And I told her my name, I introduced myself, I said I'm a Christian, and then she said, I asked her if she believes in God, and she said, God doesn't help me. And I saw she was really hard up because she was stressed. And then she told me, okay, come in. So I went into her house, and she told me the child was crying, coughing. She was really overworked. So I told her, have you prayed to God? Then she said, God doesn't help you. Didn't you hear? Come, I'll show you something. So she took me to her bathroom and showed me the medicines, what she has used for the child, and all the medicines that she has been given that child. About 2 years, that child has been sick. When not whooping cough, something else. And so I didn't know what to do. I'd never experienced any miracle. I didn't know what to do. But then I said, listen, you said God doesn't help you, but I want to still pray again for this, to this God. And then I said, okay, do what you want. So I said, give me the child. So I took the child in my hand and I prayed. A simple prayer. I said, God, you see this woman. She has said you don't help her. I myself have never seen a miracle that you've done. I've never prayed like this. But please do it that your name may be glorified, that this child may be healed. And then I left. I was so scared because I didn't know what to expect. So I left. I told her, I will come back another time, or you give me your telephone number, we'll telephone. So she gave me a telephone number. I went. I forgot to telephone. I promised I'd call after 2 days. I forgot to call. And so after a week, I was reminded to call. So I telephoned her. And then I asked, oh, how is the Aladina doing? Then she told me, you can't believe it. But after you prayed, my child got well and has been well until today. Not coughing, nothing. I was telephoning from a telephone booth, and it was summer, it was hot. I said I was sweating inside this telephone. I was shocked. The Christian who prayed and believing. I didn't know what to expect, but that God helped, where doctors had given so many medicines that could not heal. That child was healed. Later on, the brother of my husband, they had got a child in their old age. I mean, older age, not old. They were about 45, so the child was called Jennifer. So one day in the evening, I get a telephone about 10 o'clock in the night. Hello, I'm here, Manfred. I said, oh, you want to talk to your brother? I said, no, I want to talk to you. And this is a man who never used to talk to me because they were Catholics and they hated me because I became an Adventist. So I wondered, why is this man calling me and says he wants to talk to me? He doesn't want to talk to his brother. And so then he told me, Ruth, I know you pray. I said, okay. You know I pray. Yeah, why? And I could hear from his voice, Ruth, my Jennifer is very sick. She's admitted in the hospital. And they've said she will not come home at Sylvester. She will not come home anymore. And then I asked him also, have you prayed? Then he told me, for the first time I have prayed because I saw my child dying. And I'm calling you because I know you pray. Please pray for us. So I went and talked. I then asked him, do you want to talk to me, your brother? He said, no, I don't want to talk to him. So I went to bed and told the brother, your brother called. And he doesn't want to talk to you, but Jennifer is very sick, dying in hospital. And immediately this man told me to pray. It was there, pray. And okay, I prayed. But what did my prayers do? And this man believes I pray. Okay, so it was Wednesday. This man lived in Germany. And so I told my husband, let's go to Germany to see Jennifer before she dies. But I knew I was going to pray, and I was scared to say what's going to happen because I didn't know what to expect. So we went on Friday evening, arriving there late. So on Sabbath, I should have gone to the Sabbath, but something told me, you go to visit this girl in the hospital. So I went. This child was in an intensive care unit, and the mother was there with her. And when she saw me coming, I saw her with hope. And then I was scared. Now I'm supposed to bring hope. And I myself don't know what to do. But anyway, some small voice told me, you go, I've sent you. And so my husband was here, who never used to pray with me, a Catholic. And he says, I told him to go, he came with me, so we went to this intensive care unit room. I took my Bible, and I told her, Helga, I see you are hopeful, but I myself, I've only seen one case for about 2 months. But I will pray for Jennifer. Reading these words, I read these words in James 5. 13 to 18. Is any among you sick? Let him pray. Is any merry? Let him sing psalms. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick man, and the Lord shall raise him up. And if he has committed sins, they shall be forgiven him. Confess your faults one to another and pray one for another that you may be healed. The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Elias was a man subject to like passions as we are, and he prayed earnestly that it might not rain, and it rained not on the earth by the space of 3 years and 6 months. And he prayed again, and the heaven gave its rain, and the earth brought forth her fruit. Then I told her, Helga, you've heard this, what I've just read. I'm going to pray because God has said he can heal. But we leave it to him to heal, or it is his decision. So I asked the Catholics, let's kneel down, we pray. And they knelt down. Even my husband was against the Bible, against God. They knelt down because that child was sick. We knelt down and I prayed a simple prayer, then finished. And then the father came there while we were still praying. And the room was small, so I was scared also at the hope I saw with these people. And then I told my husband, let's leave. The room is too small. So we left. Then we went somewhere and left the room with them, the parents. Later on, at about 2 o'clock, that was at about 10 o'clock when we prayed. At about 2 o'clock, the father came to where we were. And then somebody asked him, how is Jennifer doing? And I was scared to hear what would have happened. I suddenly got up, I wanted to go to the toilet. And then, I went to the toilet, but opened that a door a little bit to hear what they're saying. And then he said, it is the first time that the temperature has gone down about 2 degrees after 2 weeks. That child had had her lungs had been filling with water, and it was fever and fever that could not even be measured properly. I mean, it was feeling the thermometer. And then I said, Lord, it is the first time. Then I prayed in the toilet. I knelt down in that toilet and prayed, Lord, please do something that these people may see that Adventists believe in the same God, in the God Almighty. Please do it that they may see. Before the end of that week, that child was discharged. It had recovered. And today, she's a married woman. Praise the Lord for that. I realized that the word of God is powerful. Don't stop. The word of the Lord is powerful. And I also realized that God honors his own word and his own name. After this, those parents started to believe in God. I gave them the Desire of Ages. They read. I don't know how far they are today, but that was a miracle that happened. It was not long after this, about 2 years or something, in my church, somebody got sick. And this is a lady who is, her husband, they are known anyway. She was so sick, she was very young that time, she was 15. I don't know, about 15, yeah. And she had had meningitis. And from the church, it was being announced, Priscilla is so sick. We don't think she's going to live, but let's pray for her. I asked, Priscilla, which one? Then they said the other name. Oh, that's a child who used to like me so much. She had a sister also called Iris. They used to like me so much. They come and sit next to me, although I'm black and they're white, but they really loved me. They could even come with me home and eat at my place. So when I heard that she was sick, I went and looked for her. And on that Sabbath day, I went by her bed, read the St. James. I'm not a preacher. I didn't have any olive oil. But I prayed because the word says, pray for one another. After I prayed, she also recovered. Today, she is a mother of 3 sons. They are evangelists together with her husband in Germany, doing very well. The Lord has done great wonders. I'm not trying to count only miracles, but when I hear that people say, like recently, somebody said, actually from Loma Linda, that we should not take the Bible literally. Because I took the Bible literally, God has worked. And God does not need doctors to heal others. God works through doctors to heal. God can do anything. And since that time, I've experienced so many other things. I say these things to the glory of God, that we don't think that the God of the New Testament, that Jesus and his miracles are over. If no miracles are happening now, it's because of our unbelief. It is because of our unbelief. God is still the same. He's the same in Hebrews 13:8. He said, Jesus is the same today, tomorrow, and forever. So, Jesus has done great wonders. And I could tell you many miracles. But before I stop, I'd just like to tell another one, because I'm telling it for the glory of God. The Lord has been so good, and I wonder why he shows me such great things, although I'm a sinner. The Lord is so good. I had a garden by a friend of mine. A garden. I live very far from the city. I went to look for a garden, for a place with a garden where I can grow my own crops. And this lady in particular, they gave me a place to plant my things. So I plant their potatoes and I plant everything. But this lady, she was very much against. I mean, she wasn't a believer. she's another Protestant, but not an Adventist. So anyway, like, you know, almost everybody don't like Adventists. So that was also her case. Now, it was almost winter. I was going to pick up my potatoes, and I made a silly joke. She was passing by, then I made a silly joke. What are you doing? Well, you've been married for some time. How come? Yeah, and I don't know what I was saying. Don't you want a child? Then I saw her looking at me with tears in her eyes. I didn't realize I was saying something to hurt her. So with my dirty potato full hands, I went and hugged her. And then she told me, Ruth, no, you are not wrong. It's not your mistake. Then she told me, Ruth, yes, we have been trying for a child, but it doesn't come. Maybe we'll never have any. Then I told her, Evelyn, I know you don't believe in God like I do, but God can perform miracles. So let's pray to this God that you don't believe in. He will help you. And so we prayed there by the garden. And then later on, I went home. I lived very far from where she lived. And about a year later, I get an SMS. And it is written, Ruth, I'm glad I found your telephone number. I wanted to tell you that since you prayed for me, I've already got a baby girl. I said, what? And I thank you so much for praying for me. So I took my boyfriend with me and we went and visited her. And it was such a nice experience. So although she never talked about God, she told the people around her village, God has given her a child. And that made her even to read the Bible more. And I was surprised she was not even ashamed to tell people that God has given her a child. Before that time, somebody had tried to give her the Great Controversy to read. She took it and broke it to a second-hand shop because she didn't want to read it. And then when we went home with my friend, left her with her child, then God started talking to me. Now you've prayed for this lady. You know she's not a Christian. Don't you want to go and study with her so that the Lord may show her how to bring this baby up? And then I said, my God, well, how can she? How can I shove somebody so much against religion? What am I going to tell her? So anyway, I went and brought her some presents, some baby Christian books. And then I asked her, please, would you not like to, because God has given you a baby, he has impressed me to ask you if you want that we study the Bible together so that you can know how to bring this baby up. Oh, she quickly said yes. And so we've been studying the Bible with this lady. The baby is now 4 years old and we are still studying the Bible. She's my best friend. And one time we were studying the book of Revelation, we got to Revelation 11 and or 10 or 11 about the French Revolution. Then I told her there's a thing that explains this thing very well. It's a chapter 15 in the Great Controversy. So can we read it together? And then she said, Ruth, no, we can't read it now, but I'm going on holiday. So I'll take the book with me and I'll read it on holiday. And then she said, okay, I've got enough time then to read. So she read that chapter. And then she said, oh, that book is interesting. So she said, I'll start it from the beginning. And she read it. I said, I've translated that book in my language, but I cannot write so quickly. I did not learn how to type in the school as you do here in Europe. So I can't type so quickly. And then she said, oh, Ruth, bring it. I'll type it for you. And God is such a miracle working God. This woman took my papers were addressed and this thing in Luo, and she typed it out. Later, I just do a little bit of corrections. Listen, I'm telling these things to show you that God loves sinners. He will do anything so that he can win them, even give them a baby. And this lady is my best friend today. She tells people about the Sabbath without me. It's a wonder. And that child is so precious. Another thing is, this is to show how God wants the great controversy book to be studied by many people. You can't stop the hand of God. So, I told this thing because God is good. He's a miracle-working God. Praises be to his name. He is the same God of Abraham. He is the same. He remained forever. The Lord is good. Amen.